and welcome to my second video as a bride-to-be. Today we're going to talk about a wedding fair that I participated in yesterday. And we're also going to talk a little bit about hair and what to do with it on a wedding day. So let's start talking about this wedding fair that I participated in yesterday. Before I went there, I was not sure if it was for me, if I was able to get an inspiration from that event that I was not able to find on Pinterest or elsewhere on the internet. But when I arrived, I was really, really surprised. It was so nice to see all the dresses in real life, to see the candy sticks for goodie bags, to see flower decorations, wedding venues. Even though many of the things I already decided what to do with, it was really nice to go there and to have some more inspiration for look, for colors, for details that I did not think of. One of the funniest things actually was I learned how to hold the wedding bouquet. Is that the name in English? I'm not sure, but you know the flowers that you hold when you walk the aisle? I thought that you were supposed to hold them in front of yourself or in front of the dress, but I actually learned that you have to put them on side. Like not have them here, but have them here. Otherwise you will get an ugly mark on the stomach of your dress. So, very nice detail to remember. Let's just go there and see how it looks. Telling you, there is nothing I won't do when I reach and touch your hand. Sweet melodies began. We went home for a couple of hours just to relax and enjoy all the goodie bags, another benefit of going to events like this. And then we headed out to my favorite makeup artist and hairdresser, Lynetta. She's the one I go to every time I need someone to do some magic with this. If money was no problem, then I definitely would buy her a ticket and book her a hotel room in Italy to come with me to fix hair and makeup on my wedding day. But since we have to stop somewhere and not just spend all our money on this wedding, I decided to do hair and makeup by myself. The other solution was to find a stylist in the northern part of Italy who could come and help me, but I would not be able to meet this person before the wedding day, and that will not make me feel comfortable. So I decided to do it myself, and since I am not that good, I can do it on a daily basis, but this is my wedding, I want to look perfect. I teamed up with Lynette so she could help me try to find out how to do the makeup, how to do my hair, and try to learn something from her, and some tips and tricks. So we went there together, my bridesmaid and I, and this is how it looked. So I'm sitting in the car waiting for my friend, and now we're gonna go to the hairdresser to try out some different looks for my wedding.
Hi! There is nothing I won't do.
We tried out a lot of different hairstyles and we talked about the makeup. We did not find the exact way to do my styling, but I got a lot more confident that I can do it myself. For the next month, I will just be playing around with my hair, trying to put it up, put it down, do different stuff, trying to find the right hairstyle for my wedding day. So even though we didn't find the complete styling today or yesterday, I'm definitely more confident now, and I believe I can manage to do it myself. and hopefully I will not be too nervous on the day of my wedding. If that will be the case, then luckily for me, my bridesmaid will be there and she heard everything we discussed yesterday. So I'm sure she can help me if I get a blackout. This was all for now. I hope that you enjoyed this video and yeah, please subscribe to my wedding, not to my wedding channel, my YouTube channel. And if you like my videos and would like to have some more wedding inspiration, then you might find it interesting to visit my blog as well. Otherwise, I'll see you in the next video. Bye. La, la, la.